My friend said, try and visit in the evening and see what is happening there. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. Hello friends. Welcome back to my channel, The Bulletproof Life. It's your girl, Ronke Odemwumi. And as usual, I'm delighted to have you here. Today, again, I'm on the property lane. I'm going to be talking to you about 5 mistakes to avoid when you're trying to get on the property ladder. 5 mistakes to avoid when buying a home. Now, before we get into this delicious topic, can I ask you to please press the like button on this video? Because I promise you, you're going to enjoy it. You're going to love it. So I need you to be proactive for me and press the like button. Let's get that out of the way. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do it by pressing the red button on your right. Don't forget to press the bell so you can get notifications every time I share a new video, which is on Mondays and Thursdays. So let's get into this. 5 mistakes you need to avoid when you're buying a property. Congratulations, you got your deposit together. You got your money saved. Girl, you are on top. Darling, I am proud of you. You have done well. Saving up for a property is no joke. And I've done videos about that. I've done videos, you know, talking about how you need to save up for a property. Saving up for a property is no joke. We all know that. The media calls millennials and Generation Z, generation renters now, because of how hard it is for us to get on the property ladder, how hard it is to save up a deposit and get on the property ladder. But look at you. Look at you, you've done it. You've saved up your deposit. You've dragged everything together. £10, £5, £15, £20. You saved it. And now you're trying to get on the property ladder. You're looking at houses. You're looking at the kind of houses you want to live in. You've made a list of what you like and what you don't like. You know the neighborhoods you want to go to. But there are 5 mistakes I want you to avoid as you get ready to buy your home. And the first mistake is not doing the maths. This one, it almost caught me. You know, when you're talking about buying a property, they always tell you deposit, deposit, deposit. Nobody talks about the extra fees. You need to do the maths. There are other fees attached to buying a property. And the first one, the biggest one in addition to your deposit, is your stamp duty. If your house is going to cost more than £250,000, there's going to be stamp duty on it. And your stamp duty increases as the value of your house increases. So you need to save up your stamp duty. It's going to be taken, you know, at the end of the whole process when you're paying for the home. That's when you pay for the stamp duty as well. However, lawyers, conveyancing experts, they will ask you to show evidence of that money. They want to see that you have both your deposit and your stamp duty. So the stamp duty is an extra fee you need to consider. I just mentioned lawyers. I mentioned conveyancing experts. They get paid. You need to hire a lawyer during the process and they will charge you a nice amount. It's usually a little over £1,000. It's really less than that. So that's something you need to factor in. There are survey fees. There are land registry fees. There are so many bits and pieces you need to factor in, which nobody talks about. And I'm here to talk about it. So you need to do the maths properly. You need to budget and do the maths so you know exactly how much money you need to be saving up. So you need to do the maths so that you know exactly how much money you need to have as you're going to look for property. So you're not looking for property you think you can afford when you can't afford it because of the other fees. You need to think about how much stamp duty is going to be tacked onto your deposit, you know, based on the kind of house that you're about to buy. The second mistake you need to avoid is not inspecting the property thoroughly. You know, I run a home buyers group where I support people who are trying to get on the property ladder. You know, it's a handholding service. I talk you through the process, help you understand what you need to be looking at and what you're not supposed to look at and all of that. And one thing I've noticed with a lot of people trying to get on the property ladder is this focus on the seller's decor. You go to look at a house and you're thinking, ah, it's full of furniture. The house is dirty. Ah, they had so many chairs. The house was painted red. The house was painted. You don't care. You don't care. The seller's decor is not your focus. You need to inspect the house properly. You need to look at window frames. You need to check for rot. You need to flush the toilets and check for plumbing leaks. You need to stand out on the street and look at the roof and make sure that there are no tiles missing. You need to look at the electrics. What is the wiring around the house? What does it look like? You need to go upstairs and look in the attic. You need to look in the garden. You need to inspect the house thoroughly. It's not about superficial things like paint, about the fact that the seller has a lot of furniture. Are you going to keep the seller's furniture? No, you're not. It's not your furniture. You're going to bring your own furniture. So you need to look at the house thoroughly. You need to check for damp. You need to look at the house in the way a builder would look at it. So not inspecting the house thoroughly is a mistake that a lot of buyers make, which I don't want you to make. That is the second mistake you need to watch out for. Not inspecting the house thoroughly. Make a list of things you want to look at when you are going to look at that house and tick them off. Don't be afraid to ask questions. Ask your seller questions, you know. So inspect the house thoroughly. The third mistake is not checking the location. Location. Location is everything when you're buying a property. There is a saying, buy the worst house on the nicest street. That's because location matters. Location matters to how well your property will increase in value. It matters to how you will enjoy the property. It matters to everything. You know, when I was trying to get on the property ladder, there was a house my husband and I went to look out that we loved. This house was beautiful. It was huge. It had gardens for miles. You know, the garden went on and on and on. It was beautiful. I was also making that mistake that a lot of buyers make. I was looking at the seller's decor and the house was beautifully decorated. You know, the seller had music interest. There was a piano here, a cello there, a trombone there, a violin there. I was feeling very posh. I was looking at the house and imagining myself living in the house with the seller's decor. All the while, I wasn't considering the location. There was something very wrong with the location that I wasn't aware of. So along the way, I spoke to a friend who is in the property business, who is actually a house agent, values houses and all of that. And when I spoke to my friend said, oh, that house, are you aware of the pub that is two doors down the street from that house? I said, yes, there's a pub there. My friend said, try and visit in the evening and see what is happening there. Ladies and gentlemen, that pub was rowdy. It was noisy in the night. You had boys hanging around drinking. You know, it was a very, very rowdy, loud space. I was not aware of this. I was busy looking at the seller's interior. I forgot about the location entirely. I ran away from that house. My legs were touching the back of my head the way I ran away from that house. And that is the mistake I'm here to tell you about. Location matters. You need to consider how close your location is to amenities. How close is it to train stations if you're a commuter? How close is it to schools? How close is it to shops? How easy is it for you to access all the things that you need? It matters. If you move into the X, if you move into a really, really nice, quiet village, but you're not close to anything, it's possible that your house value is going to be impacted. It's also possible that it will impact your experience of living in that place. And then when it's time to sell, you will struggle to sell that house, or you will struggle to get value for that house over time, simply because it's not close to amenities. I mean, if you're in a house where there is no internet connection, or the internet connection is bad, all the internet providers cannot get to you easily, and so your network, you have to be standing around corners of the house to use your phone or to use your laptop. That's not a positive experience, is it? So location is the third mistake I want you to avoid making as you're going about buying your home. Not listening to expert advice. I mentioned earlier that I spoke to a friend who is in the property space, who values houses as a house agent, and who pointed out that pub to me. So that's the thing. You need to listen to expert advice. You need to listen to people who have done the journey repeatedly. You need to listen to house agents. You need to listen to what your surveyor is telling you. So I've heard of home buyers who hired surveyors to survey a property. You have to do this. There are two levels of surveys you can do. And the surveyor has come back to you and provided you some red flags. They've told you about some red flags in the house, but you just blow it aside and you're like, it doesn't matter. They're just being pedantic. It doesn't matter. I'll buy the house anyway. Well, you haven't listened to expert advice, and you're going to regret it. If an expert gives you an advice, consider it seriously, because the expert has nothing to lose or gain if you buy or don't buy the house, because the expert is not going to live in the house and they're not going to benefit from the price increase or the value increase of that house over the next few years. So it's very important that you listen to your lawyers, you listen to your surveyors, you listen to your house agents when they mention something about the house. Hightail it the way I did when they mentioned the pub to me and asked me to go and have a look at that pub. So it's very important that you listen to expert advice. Not listening to expert advice is a mistake you don't want to make when you're buying property. That brings me to the very, very last mistake you don't want to make. And that is not considering house efficiency. So houses now come with something called an EPC value, which starts from A to E or F, even G. And you need to consider the EPC value of a house. If the house you are trying to buy has an EPC value of G or F, or even E, you need to be aware that you're buying a house that is not energy efficient. It means that your electric bills are going to be higher, your gas bills are likely to be higher, your utility bills are going to be higher, and it also means you're going to end up with a colder house, which is not a positive experience in winter. Now, a trick a lot of sellers play is that when they see you're about to come and view the house in winter, they crank up the heating. So you come into a house that is super warm, that is warm and toasty and welcoming, and so you forget the EPC rating. You don't take note of it. You think, oh, well, when I went there, the house was really warm. No, that doesn't matter. The fact that you have gone into a house and is nice and toasty and warm when you visit, it does not mean that that warmth is not coming at a high cost. So it's very important that you consider the efficiency of the home you're about to buy and what that is going to cost you. So EPC rating is something you want to check. If the EPC rating is not provided when they advertise the home, feel free to ask, what is the EPC rating of this house? So now I've shared with you 5 mistakes you need to avoid making as you buy your first home. I hope this video is of value to you. I hope you are going to keep these 5 points in mind as you go around looking at your home. Please let me know when you get on the property ladder. And if you have used this my points, let me know. Send me an email, send me a message. Let me know that this video has added value to you. If you are finding the home buying journey lonely or complex or confusing, get in touch with me. I have a home buyers group which I run for first time buyers. You know, it's a group of people who are all trying to get on the ladder, and I'm there providing handholding. I'm there providing support. I'm there asking questions that you don't want to ask other people. You don't want to ask your lawyer. You don't even know who to ask. I'm there answering those questions, pointing you in the right direction, telling you to ask your lawyer things, ask your surveyor these things, ask your agent these things, ask the house seller these things. You know, I'm pointing out red flags and things like that. So if you are somebody who's finding the home buying journey a little bit too complex or a little bit lonely, get in touch with me and let's talk about you joining the home buyers group. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, darling, please do it. Please press the red button on your right. Don't forget to press the bell so you can get notifications every time I share a new video. If you haven't pressed like on this video, you've come this far, you've enjoyed this video, please press like on this video. Until my next video, you take care of yourself. Thank you for watching and keep living that bulletproof life. Bye-bye.